cookies. Accept cookies. Accept cookies. We do that all the time when we're online, and I do it just as much as anybody else does. But what are we doing when we accept a cookie? What is a cookie? One of the things that happens when you go with your browser, whether it's Chrome or Safari or Firefox or something else, to a website, one of the things that the website can do is to ask your browser to set a cookie, where setting a cookie means just to deposit it, for the browser to accept the cookie and store it. And the cookie is essentially a shortish, often arbitrary string of numbers and letters. Typically, it's unique. What websites do is to store a different cookie for each visitor, and their browsers store the cookie in the memory of the user's device, their laptop or their phone. And then when that browser returns to the same website, the website can retrieve the cookie. In other words, can instruct your browser to send the cookie back. And what this does is to enable websites to remember their users, so to speak. And it's essential to things like buying stuff online, because of course, if you put something into your online shopping cart, and then you put a second thing into your shopping cart, the website needs to know that it's the same person, or to be more precise, the same browser operated on the same device. It's the same person putting the thing into the shopping cart. That's called a first party cookie, because it's set by the website that you're visiting, and it's essential to everyday operations, like I said, and it's pretty much uncontroversial. No one other than that website, no web domain other than that website can retrieve the cookie. That's a basic principle of web design, that cookies can be retrieved only by the website, the web domain that has set them. They can't be retrieved by any other system, any third party, so to speak.